everybody. It's the program. We're on TV. Once again, with today, we're doing Turn the Machines, then we start talking.
We'll be here for an hour.
Yeah, here we go. Look at this. Look at this. It's Tuesday.
Yeah.
And it's the daytime. And we're back here on the couch again. This is one of those times when we record at night and then in the day. Sometimes we have close times, sometimes we have far times. Today is a closer time.
Yeah. So I sighed because I had kind of an interesting night last night. After I got out of the studio, I left my keys here. So I got as far as the foot of 4th Avenue Bridge before I realized my predicament, and it was 10:45. And I was like, oh crap, I got maybe around 15 minutes to catch up with Kenny.
Yeah.
And so I traveled around from the foot of the 4th Avenue Bridge to State Capitol. I saw that the office wasn't open anymore. The lights weren't on, so I was like, okay, gotta continue on to the transit station, and I saw Kenny, and then I was like, okay, now I'm going to retrieve my keys and give Kenny his keys back. So that was probably the duration of that was probably around 10 minutes or whatever.
Yeah, you were fast. You must have made it from the hill to where I was in 5 minutes or less.
Yeah, it was like, it was kind of exhausting a little bit. It was really exhausting once I climbed back up to the hill to get to my my place of residence, and I was like, oh gosh, crashing, because it was like to be honest, I had an about face as soon as I got, you know, to that parking lot behind Childhood's End. I was like, did I lock the door? Did I lock everything? I need to make sure that I locked everything. So I made sure that I locked everything. And then I just...
Where's Childhood's End?
Went... that's the gallery over there by the Cassine statue.
And you turned around again?
Yeah, I turned around again.
So you, like, got the keys from me.
Yeah.
Went to the studio.
Yeah.
Went back, went to the other end, and then you turned around again to make sure you locked everything?
Yeah. Yeah, it was kind of a messed up day. And
you
it really
that
it was when I got home, and it was like 11:45. It was like almost midnight, and I was like, I'm ready for bed. So I usually have, my bedtime is usually slightly before midnight.
Wow, really? You used to step at like 4 a.m.
Yeah.
Was the... the studio locked when you came back to check on it?
Oh, yeah.
Hey,
there we go. I went saved on the brink of time, I guess. Or nick of time?
Oh.
Who was that?
I don't know. I wasn't able to answer.
Fair enough. So, you know, I was like kind of petered out. Not that I don't have... lots of duration and whatever within me. I remember eating these kind of like, they were semi candy bars, but they were like power bars with like chocolate and chopped nuts in them and whatever. And I remember eating another form of power bars before that was just like the straight peanut butter or the straight, you know, chocolate flavored or whatever. I had two different varieties, and I only mention this because I would be eating one or the other. The straight flavored power bars I would get at Costco.
What's the straight flavor? They gotta have some kind of flavor.
Yeah. And the one that was
no flavor.
Well, I don't know what no flavor was, but you know, they Costco would sell chocolate, peanut butter, vanilla, and then at Costco, Target, I would get these power bars that were kind of like candy bar oriented, but they had on the packaging or whatever they say, you know, mental, physical recovery, endurance, you know, whatever.
It's endurance flavor.
There's not really an endurance.
Recently attempted to contact you in regards to an online business. Your name and information were referred to me as somebody that was open to opportunity. If that is still the case, simply stay on the line and a brief 2-minute recording will play and give you some information as to what it is we have. If you like what you hear, leave us a message and we'll get back to you directly to answer some questions and get you the rest of the info.
We're getting
Hi, folks. Thank you for taking the time to listen to this 2-minute message. Now, what you're about to discover is the most powerful income-generating business that's ever hit the home-based business industry. In just 2 months, I was able to...
Wow.
Wow.
We're getting solicited to... That was weird.
Yeah. And that was the number that just came in and hung up after you answered it or whatever?
Yeah.
Ugh. Well, I would only mention the power bars because I would route between the donation area and the loading dock, and that was kind of draining as well, walking back and forth to make another Gaylord or whatever. Take that to the pricing station, swap it out with a container that was maybe halfway full of glass or toys or God only knows what, and it was kind of a challenge. So I kind of thought about that whole experience as I was trudging back home kind of like sea legs or whatever, like water, when you're walking through.
Is it so much harder to walk home than it was on a normal day?
Oh, just because I was kept on rushing back and forth.
Oh, yeah. You're in too much of a hurry. You can take it easy.
Yeah. I mean, that was fine. Yeah. Probably wasn't had as much sea legs as I lend myself to elicit that information.
You could have used endurance power bar, huh?
Perhaps, yeah. Yeah, to had maybe, 5 minutes of eating it and relaxing and waiting on the curb and whatnot. I don't know. Downtown is not really too inviting until you go like to the library and have an actual chair to sit down, or you go into Starbucks and you can have an actual chair to sit down. I mean, there are certainly people that sit at
hospital.
There are certainly people that sit on curbs and even bus stops and they just shoo the driver past once a bus comes. And I could probably have done that too, but I don't know.
You could just sit on the sidewalk anywhere.
It was kind of maybe time to go home and sleep.
I think it's better to just power through it, though. You don't need to get a little break. That's not going to help you that much.
No, it's not.
Once you get up, it'll be worse.
Yeah. Anyway, I got up around 8 o'clock today, and I was like, okay, I don't really want to walk downtown, so I drove myself instead. And I realized that my group doesn't start at 9:45, but 9:30, you know, at least for the next week until the quarter, like, switches over. So hopefully I'll remember that, you know, it's not 9:30, or it's 9:45, it's 9:30, but whatever.
Were you late?
Yeah.
They started at 9:30?
Only 20 minutes, but I was able to check in and mention that whole fiasco that I had last night.
Are they like in a circle of chairs and you say stuff and you share stuff like
no, it's more like a table with a long end and a short end, kind of like maybe people's conventional kitchen tables or whatnot.
Is this really big?
Yeah.
There's like it can, how many people are in a group? Like 30?
No. 8.
Oh, that's it?
10 people.
That's it?
Yeah, something like that.
I always thought it was like 30 people in a circle.
No. But I could certainly talk to 30 people at once.
Yeah. They're your friends, the group people now?
No.
Instead of them with it once a week in a chair, 8 people, it seems like. Be their friend.
Well, actually, I'm there pretty much every day of the week. I was also at the socialization / lunchtime, and they had so many different cherries of pie set out there that I had 3 different slices.
Pie?
Of pie.
Wow, what kind of pie?
Cherry.
All cherry?
Yeah.
And they just had like tons of cherry pies?
Yeah.
Like how many?
Like maybe they had around 8 other slices left or something. 8.
So how many, 10, whole, 12, how many whole pies did they have?
They didn't have any whole pies. They had all these different pies to break off into pieces or whatever.
It was pre-sliced?
Yeah. Sweet cherry pie.
It was like 10 slices of pre-sliced pie?
Yeah, that's a Warrant song if anyone doesn't know.
If you ate 3 out of 10 slices, that's a lot. That's, you ate like a third of the pie.
Yeah.
I mean, how many other people got pie? Everybody that wanted it?
I think the whole lunchroom at least had 1 slice. Or if not everyone, then 75% of the people there had at least 1 slice. So sometimes there's a lot of food that goes through there. And then I'm like, well, why not eat, you know, some of this myself? So it was fun. And then I just basically left my car at their parking lot and just walked over here. Sometimes I treat that parking lot as kind of like a carpool place. And I'll drive
like it's
home.
Some kind of parking lot.
Yeah, well, I'm certainly not wanting to park on the curb. And parking on the curb, I would get a ticket in the heartbeat with my luck. So that's all but one good, I guess.
Here we go. We're going to play the dice game. We're writing some numbers down on our hands between 1 and 6. We're trying to visualize the future. Wait, is this even... What day is it? 21st, yeah.
It is the 21st.
It's Tuesday. It's feeling real. Feeling real.
That's because it's the only real day of the week.
Here it goes. Six, I lost.
I did too.
I'm going to look at the phone.
Messages.
Who's this?
Wee. Okay. I missed your call, motherfucker.
Big surprise.
I guess it was because you forgot to call me the day before or something. I forgot all about it.
Huh? You forgot all about us?
Okay, I got a new idea.
How is that possible?
Marijuana flavored cheesy puffs.
Marijuana flavored cheese?
Marijuana fucking cheesy puffs. Yeah.
I heard that cheese was addicting, but
oh, man,
I
don't
need to
dream,
go overboard, see? Motherfucker.
Well, that was a weird message.
Especially Cheetos. I'm sure Cheetos is three times as addictive as normal cheese. But you would eat Cheetos after getting smoking a bowl, I'm sure. Or maybe you would eat a brick of cheese.
Yeah, a whole brick. Is that why you're eating?
I don't know.
You ever wanted to eat a whole brick of cheese recently? You thought about it?
No.
Never even questioned it?
Not really.
You never see it? We go to the store and you see the cheese block and not something you're trying to resist?
No.
Hello?
Hi. You reached Critic Dobler. If you leave me a message with your name and number, I'll call you back as soon as I can. Thanks.
Thanks, Freddy. Freddy, it's a program. You can call us back. It's Tuesday. Goodbye.
Later. I did attend a board meeting, though, at First Christian Church. On the, they had,
you're on the board now?
Well, not me personally, but there was, somebody that was leaving the board after 50 years or something, or 25 years. He's been, kind of like, a rock of stability for the board, or
the what church?
First Christian, but...
What is the First Christian? You're going to First Christian Church?
Yeah, I went to First Christian Church because they had, the groups that I go to, they don't really have this kind of,
at the church?
Yeah, they had a board meeting at the church. They don't really have this wide open, spacious area. That's where I would normally find Jennifer on Sundays before taking her to a board game group. If she didn't go to a Unitarian church, she would be at this other church, and I would come by and pick her up, and it's a pile linoleum floor. I don't know how to pronounce
it. Linoleum.
Thank you.
Linoleum.
You're welcome. So, anyway.
You can say linoleum.
Linoleum.
There you go. You'll remember. Linoleum. Linoleum.
Right.
Linoleum.
Right. Yeah. So, they had this wide open area. Sometimes she would be munching on food and whatnot, and they had food for people to munch on themselves. And believe it or not, they had cheese there.
And, I believe it.
In these wax wrapping things or whatever, so I kept on eating the little 1 ounce, whatever they were, and they were like maybe 10. Or something. I don't know.
I think there's too many. And 10 ounces is like a whole pack, is like a, pretty much a brick.
Yeah, so I guess maybe my body was craving for the protein or whatever, and I certainly used that protein later on that day. Jeez, by running back and forth.
Maybe all that protein causes you to get running, though, and get confused and have to run.
Yeah, well, either way, hopefully I'm not, you know, going to be a mouse in my next life. But if I am, you know, that's all well and good, I guess.
What did they do at the board meeting? Did you make it? Did you make a decision? Are you going to try to get that spot? You should try to get that spot that the guy's retiring. You could get that spot.
Well, yeah, I could get it, that spot, but I don't know how much use I would be for the board or whatever.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's almost like TCTV. You know, Reagan said, you know, hey, why don't you get on the board?
What I do, like, on the board, yeah.
Okay. But
you just do nothing on the board.
The people,
on the board. Ah, I'll tell you, like,
yeah.
Yeah.
Well, the people of TCTV, the higher ups, probably were not having much of, you know. Do you have any? They wanted to know whether or not I had a accounting experience or
yeah.
something like that.
And they wanted you,
like,
to be an accountant.
No, I don't. The only kind of accounting that I have is counting pennies at the end of the month.
That's a good one. That's a joke.
It's honest.
Well, that's a joke, though. That's what a joke is. The only counting I do is counting pennies at the end of the month. But I'm ching. Like, that's a classic joke. Let's watch Memory Boys. You want to watch a song by the Memory Boys?
Sure.
So we're taking it down even further.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, thanks, yeah.
It's going to be on a loud note.
Oh,
she's in my head.
Oh, is there a lot of sound in the voice or Alright, Memory Boys, thank you.
Now it's info time.
You're watching your daily hour with me. It's our Long Harp Live call-in television talk show that's recorded every day in Thurston County, 7 days a week, 365 days a year, 366 days on leap years. YDHWM began on September 19, 2010, and tapes a week in advance. So if you're watching this program at 11:30 p.m., this episode taped on the same weekday of the previous week. If you're watching this program at 2 a.m., this episode taped on the same day than the month of the previous year. You can also watch any episode of the program on YouTube.com. Anyone can come on the program, especially you. We rely on the community for content, so give us a call at 360-836-4384 and leave a message. We'll play your message on the next episode of the program, and we'll give you a call back. And now, welcome back to the program.
Yeah,
I don't ever really want to be in charge of any organizations or nonprofits, money or source of income or whatever, but since I deal in paper money myself, you know, at the end of the month I always got all these different bags of coins everywhere, or just not just bags, but little piles of pennies.
Yeah, what do you need to get a piggy bank or a jar.
Or I could just, you know, pay for and one or two items at
Your call has been forwarded to an automatic voice message system. 3-6-0-5-6-1-1-0-3-5 is not available.
Mr. Gimson, it's the program.
Wake up, sir.
Yeah.
You got pot cheese or cheese pot, or is there a Cheetos pot?
So why don't you have a bank, Carl?
I do have a bank. I just don't have a piggy bank. But
why don't you have like a checking account?
Yeah.
But why don't you have a
Well, I'm not going to put the pennies back into it.
Why?
If I could go to some sort of like self-service pay thing, and I could just drop the coins in the coin acceptor at Fred Meyer or Safeway or whatever, and just like buy a 2-liter pop or something.
That costs like 10% though.
Huh?
Those change counters, they're like, that costs like 10%.
No. I paid the merchandise directly.
Oh, in quarter?
Yeah,
okay.
In quarters and pennies and whatever. You know, it seems to be more trouble than it's worth to sometimes even go to the credit union downtown. They have a coin acceptor, and it spits out a receipt, and you take that receipt to the teller at the windows or whatever, the counters at the bank, and they say, hey, I deposited this money, I like to have this money in my bank account, and what is it? It's like $1.56 in change.
That's it.
You know, whatever. You know,
so you still could get a jar. You still could get a jar.
Well, I
and
could,
then you have all these little piles, and then you could grab your jar and go.
You have reached the maximum time permitted for recording your message. If you are satisfied with your message, press 1. To listen to your message, press 2. To message review.
Wake up, sir.
Yeah.
You got pot, cheese, or is there a Cheetos pot?
Why don't you have a bank, Carl?
I do have a bank. I just don't have a piggy bank. But
why don't you have like a checking account?
To send your message with normal delivery, press 1. To send your message with urgent delivery, press 2. Thank you. Your message has been sent. Goodbye.
Yeah, well, I do have a Tostitos, like, a jar that had cheese in it.
Cheese jar? What? Like cheese whiz? Like,
yeah.
You bought that stuff?
Like I have bought that stuff before.
The liquid cheese? Nacho cheese?
Yeah.
What do you eat it on it with?
Sometimes I eat it straight.
You eat it out of the jar? With a spoon or what?
Well, yeah.
That's gross.
I've eaten a brick of cheese before, yeah, and that was probably gross.
The brick of cheese is a little bit less gross than eating straight up nacho cheese sauce.
Well, whatever.
Why don't you put it on your bread or something?
I'm not a person that pleases people all the time.
If I was, then
I would be like maybe Martha Stewart or something.
There's a difference between trying to please people all the time and eating cheese whiz out of the jar. You don't have to please people all the time.
Well, I would say that someone would be maybe slightly ornery, but. No.
You?
Me, not me. You.
Oh, well, why don't you say it then? Cheese whiz?
Well, it's because my brain is now all mushy and all yogurt-like and with all this, you know, liquid whatever that I eat, you know, every day. But, you know, I don't know. So, some of these jars I've had for 3 years or whatever, and I still put coins in them every once in a while, but, you know, other times I don't. Other times I just have these growing piles through my apartment, and it's like, okay, time to dump the coins. I mean, certainly it would be easier to dump the coins directly in my pants or whatever before I go off to Safeway or Target or Fred Meyer or wherever I want to go to buy, you know, something like a 2-liter pop bottle or I don't know. That's not too expensive.
How many pounds do you have right now?
At home?
Mm-hmm.
Zero.
Oh, that's good.
Yeah.
Where's all your change then?
I'm actually carrying it with me, so.
How much change do you have on you right now?
I don't know. I just.
Well, let's look.
Oh, jeez.
Like a lot? Whoa, that was quite a bit. Whoa. Do you go to the store?
Yeah.
And you actually pay with things with pennies?
Yeah. I mean, if they have a monetary value, why not use them?
Yeah, but they shouldn't count up the pennies?
Well, I don't count pennies. I just grab a handful of change, and I'm sure I got, you know, I got a dollar in that really small pocket by the, you know, large pocket. It's like a pocket big enough to hold like just like a couple of keys or whatever. So
I bet they count. So you make them count the change, the pennies?
No. I don't go to the actual. I don't deal with the people. I can just put the coins in the coin receptor.
Oh, at the self-serve thing?
Yeah.
Oh, that makes more sense.
I
that makes more sense, huh?
Well, yeah. Good one, Kenny.
Yeah.
So I don't really want to waste anyone's time, really.
Yeah. That's a good use of those machines, I guess.
Yeah.
Because that's like a free counter.
Yeah, basically. I mean, people can... and I have sat and stood behind people as they... at Safeway, as they figure out their coupons or whatever.
Yeah.
And, you know, sometimes that's almost too much effort to wait in line behind people like that.
You know,
until I remember that, you know, for example, on an opportunity like this, when I'm going to Safeway, and I just want, you know, something inexpensive that I'm you know, whatever.
Those things will probably count or give you back dollars, too. If you put in a bunch of change and you want dollars back, you could probably just put in all your change and then whatever you buy your stuff, and then you also get your money back in dollars instead of change.
Yeah, well, whatever. I mean, I got quarters, nickels, and dimes here, and I got a whole dollar bill as well. So I'm reason to believe that, you know, that there's at least 180 cents, you know, total that I have.
Yeah.
Maybe.
And you're going to go buy a soda?
Yeah.
You want a Mountain Dew? You can have a can. They're right there.
Mm.
Do you like a Mountain Dew? Do you not want it because I bought them? Is that a thing you're thinking about?
Would... Okay. Fine.
You can have one?
Push
you into it? Why don't you use, you know what?
I can't multitask. All right, fine. Fuck it.
You know what you should do? Oh, yeah. He's just not doing things he doesn't want to do. There it goes. Click, click. He's doing it. Good.
I was going to drink my. I was going to drink my megaphone. I mean, microphone. Not megaphone. Oh, Jesus. Now I can gather my coins in peace.
Yeah.
Oh, God. Heaven help me. Well, heaven help people that are, like... They have not one eyebrow raised, but two eyebrows raised. As they continue to listen to me and all this different nonsense about... Did I lock the door? I'm gonna go back and check. Whatever. I mean, maybe that's good policy.
Hello?
Hello, Dan.
We're making it. I'm talking to Marilyn. I can't talk right now.
Oh, okay.
Bye.
Bye. Talking to Marilyn.
Jesus.
What's next? Dice game?
Yeah, let's do that.
Here it is.
Yeah. Look at that dice spin. That is a wonderful background. The alpine of, I don't know. Mount Rainier, who knows?
Oh yeah, here we go. Six, six, two, I lost again.
Hey, Mr. Ginsu is gonna come out with a bang if he chooses six today.
Yeah, but is he? He's not even on the phone.
We tried calling him, did we?
Yeah, I didn't answer.
Yeah, right.
Yeah, I want to see if that's the Memory Boy's last song.
Yeah.
Boy,
let's do it.
We still got another song.
Alright, ready for the folk dance?
Yeah. Kitty Chance was a follow. I don't know.
All right. Well, that's all the phone stuff that we had to do. I think it's all the messages and all that stuff. I kind of want to call Alex Paxton back again. He was calling yesterday. Alright, here we go. I want to talk to those solicitors too. I don't know who they were. Who is soliciting us?
Maybe that's a surprise to know on an upcoming episode viewers.
Find out who's soliciting us.
The mailbox belonging to
Alex
is full. Cannot accept new messages at this time. To leave a callback number, press 5. Or please try again later.
Goodbye.
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 You want an orange call?
No.
They got vitamin C.
Yeah, I know they. I had 3 pieces of cherry pie. And,
yeah, pie has fruit in it, huh?
Yeah.
But does it count?
Well, I don't know. I mean, it doesn't seem like that I have a whole lot of room because I also had a banana in one of those peanut butter, like
Cliff bars.
Yeah, from this one group. The facilitator gives out Nature Valley peanut butter bars or whatever.
Yeah.
He gets from Costco, so.
How do you know where he gets them?
Because he has mentioned that he gets them at Costco before.
At no additional charge, AT&T can help you find a similar business in the...
Yes, that sounds like a great idea. Click.
Want to look at an episode from the past?
Sure, I can go over my shoulder.
Yeah, go over your shoulder. Find a real old one. Yeah, wow, 2010. Is it going to be one that we already looked at from that pile, the low pile? Here it goes. What's that one from? December 11th, 2010, on a Saturday. Whoa!
Way the camera buzzes when we get to extreme close-up.
Oh, absolutely. I love it when you see the digital...
I gotta rewind him for... Yeah.
That was probably a mistake.
Alright, well, I'm gonna... Well, we're doing 2010, maybe this is the first couple of months of the program. October... I don't even know how we ended up with the,
Hey, everybody, it's your daily hour with me. We're on every night here at 11:30 p.m. You can call the number. The number's down here. It's 330-536-3802. It's Lewis.
Hey, everyone.
We're out here on Saturday, and we're going to be talking for an hour.
Wow.
We caught some McDonald's. Uh-oh, what the?
A bunch of people.
I was in the back room.
Wow.
Did you ever go back there?
Yeah. Well, I met your mom there before you went up to, somewhere north to visit your cousin or nephew or someone getting born.
In 2012, huh?
Yeah.
That was when the Obama became the president for the second time. Who's going to be the president, Carl? Is it over yet? When did they figure out the primary?
I'm not a fortune-telling person.
Did they figure out the primaries yet, though, or whatever it's called?
Oh, no, it's not going to happen until, I guess... But
I didn't even notice Rihanna in there until just now.
Rihanna!
In, July. Last week of July.
Here it is.
Wow.
Yeah! Woo! On TV, where are we?
Yeah, that's...
There we are.
We're doing an hour with me today. We're going to turn on the machines and we start talking. We're going to be talking here for an hour.
Yeah.
It's Saturday.
Here I am again.
Yeah, this is a
know me.
100 over 120 days, I think.
Yeah.
This is why this is light on. We have a light on in the middle of the day.
Yeah, it's kind of... Well, I was going to say it's kind of dark in this room, but I'm wearing sunglasses, so probably is why I think it's dark.
It is not that dark, but I want to turn off this light. Oh, it's kind of... Too... Wait, when was the last time you were here?
Did I come during the week at all? I think it might have been last Saturday.
Last Saturday. You see anything there on the streets there in the last week?
Yeah.
That couch is really hard to get into that room.
I don't think so.
It's pretty much snug.
This is my Oran Coker's last day. That was on the streets, though. That was in a store.
In the store, yeah. Whatever. What happened with that?
I wore a suit. And there was a party with cake, sort of. I was trying to convince her to come on the program, and she was like, no, I'm scared. And I was like, it's not that big of a deal. But I guess she said she was going to watch it and maybe get her husband to call in. So, Sarah Dickinson, call the number, 330-536-3802.
Or 360-836-4334.
Leave your voicemail.
From, still.
Get into the voicemails.
I might have made this background tape.
Leaving a message. Why am I leaving a message? Because Kenny told me to do it.
You did.
I do whatever Kenny tells me to do.
Oh, great.
Which is why I've killed a lot of people. So anyway.
Why you want
I
that?
I have one more thing to say.
Yeah?
You guys need to replace that Dance Only Dance advertisement.
Oh, yeah.
Feces, man. It looks okay. I don't pay good money to you guys as a sponsor for you to run that stupid, shitty-looking ad. Okay? Fix it. Bye.
He's not happy with the quality, the video quality of the ad.
Yeah. It doesn't look as good as it looked before.
Yeah, it's been degraded.
Watching that ad.
Wait, did you actually pay money?
No.
Right. Okay.
People doing
he's also talking about murder.
The line dancing.
Not a very good joke.
I remember that.
The line dancing.
Yeah. Where the like a series of people.
Yeah, we'll call him back though.
Or whatever.
Let's see if he's awake now.
Centipede or millipede or whatever.
Not be awake early.
Kind
of early today.
And
it's before noon. We have a busy day today.
Hosting all freaking night. Let's see if you guys go to that last week. Did you have a good time?
Did the jello thing work out? Because we're about to spend a couple hours making jello.
Try making the jello. I don't know. I've never made jello before. I think I might have made pudding.
Made jello before.
In the past, but I don't think I've ever actually even tried to make jello before.
I feel like I was maybe like kind of helped my mom.
Who? Jealous?
Jello.
Jello.
You never stirred up emotions?
Jello would always be made by my grandmother or my parents or whatever. liver liver by me. No.
Please
Hello?
Enter your remote access
no.
code.
Nope.
Exactly.
Hey, it's the program. How are you doing?
All right.
Were you sleeping?
No.
Oh, great. So we didn't wake up. I was worried that we were going to wake up.
Did you just tell me no?
Not this time, no. I'm totally awake.
Oh, good. It's almost, that was Veterans Day was before. That's tomorrow, I guess. It's almost tomorrow's Veterans Day.
Veterans Day? Uh-oh.
Yeah.
It's Veterans Day.
It's also Thanksgiving.
We must honor our veterans.
Yeah.
Let's do it.
Honor some veterans today, viewer viewers. Thanks, veterans. You were veterans there.
Thank you.
Yeah, we degraded the tape there because I think the producer, or Desmond, the intern, he made the last tape, and he ended up using an episode and got the commercial off of the episode, which was already on video. So it's like got like a double video effect on it. There.
Today?
Yeah, that's
pretty messed up.
Yeah,
no, I haven't.
We're sorry. You have reached a number that has been disconnected or no longer in service. If you feel you have reached this recording in error, please check the number and try your call again.
Oh no, the phone's cutting out.
Did you celebrate Halloween?
My cell phone's cutting out.
Halloween. Nope, okay, bye. Oh,
okay, bye.
Bye-bye, there it goes, yeah.
So,
I don't know,
one,
we're
two,
off the
five,
it seems like his phone was
two,
not working, so.
Six, six. Go. So, twos and sixes.
Yeah, also, what else did I do this week?
Two,
I went to the festival opening and got all glammed up for the Velvet Gold Mine.
The Velvet Gold Mine, yeah, the film festival was last week, I think. I wanted to be talking about it last week, but
Wanda.
I forgot to.
Yeah,
Wanda.
Well, it's still going. It's
Wanda and
second to last.
Cornelia
Golf. Is it on Sunday?
Yeah, Sunday is the closing night. I took the Philip Kaufman. I think it's the other movies that day.
Oh, so tomorrow you can go see Philip Kaufman. If you're still watching.
I'm sorry?
Don't take orange milkshakes.
I'm sorry, one more time.
Arctic. Orange milkshakes.
No, we do not.
Oh, do you know when?
I'm sorry?
When?
I do not.
Yeah, but when?
I don't know, but we're not that famous. Yeah, I think it was pretty famous. Did that Bob Dylan movie that came out a couple of years ago? I didn't really know that much about him, honestly. I mean, I'd seen that one before.
Maybe they should have.
I don't believe we're getting that.
Oh, are you looking at the calendar?
I'm sorry?
Did you look at the calendar?
Yes.
Oh, okay, not on the calendar?
No.
Oh, that's too bad. So
sorry about that.
Usually come, I'm sorry, also. Hey, it usually comes out in the summertime.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
Yeah.
I don't see it.
Summer starts. Oh, it's summer is starting.
I'm
gonna,
sorry?
It's summer right now. It's summertime.
Oh. No, I didn't pick that guest straight. But when
well, you can't please everyone.
Yeah.
Fell
out of bed,
I was
going
to say, you
can't. And then
you might want to answer the phone call with less beeping and background noise.
For them?
Yeah.
Oh, well, yeah, but they're McDonald's, everything's beeping all the time.
Well, there could be quieter places to maybe answer a phone call, but he might have been emptying out the fry containers from the deep fryers or whatever.
Well,
or
had
an associate do that for them or something.
Yeah. Yeah,
it's
time for the desk
interviews.
Oh,
wait, we didn't play last year's episode.
Oh.
Hey, John! Write a number on your
Yes?
How you doing?
How you doing?
Hey, we gotta look at the commercial, John. I saw you downtown.
The Honda Giant used car.
Yeah.
How was that?
Pardon? What did you say?
No. You didn't see me.
No, I didn't see you, Dad. I didn't see you, Dad. I didn't see you,
Carl.
I didn't see you there.
Carl.
Yeah, hey, lady. It's commercial.
Hey, Mandy.
Yeah, you're...
Summertime. Love it or hate it, we're going to talk about it.
Well, the color is not wrong on my face. It really is getting a little bit dark.
It's hot. Mandy's back.
No.
McDonald's.
Be dead, but
hey John, what are you doing right now? Watching TV, huh?
What's on TV, John? Thanks to Mr. Gensu and
any last McDonald's?
The Lewis?
Appointment for the discovery of LASIK is
what's on TV?
The
Port Commission meeting.
Ask about an extra $400 off your all-laser LASIK procedure. That's $200 off per eye. We've already performed over 2 million. Let us help you. Discover how you can get the quality LASIK.
Good enough for me.
We got told about around 6 o'clock last night.
Yeah? What about it?
Wow.
And do our job, so careers in radio aren't all behind the mic.
Hey, Bill, Carl, there's a meeting Monday.
What are you going to do then? Red Bird, Roger, Scott, Still, Steve, Zinger, Trini, Zilker? You're from FBI! Thank you! TCTV, LeBay, Bay, Jody, Fabulous, SupplyPod.com.
And he's welcome to come to the
10
Rounds Coffee Chat, too.
Bye!
Bye.
Commercial.
See commercials.
We're not selling anything though.
Hey, somebody give me a dollar. Carl saw some crazy things. Some people in Congress are sitting down. There was a drug bust at the sports store.
Yeah.
Somebody got shot. Mr. Gensu, you what happened to you?
What?
You got well, not proposed to, but kind of, and then you turn them down, then you give them the card. Because you can just have love problems. If you can't love yourself, how the hell are you going to love somebody else? Can I get an amen?
We're on the
message. Get on TV.
I did say amen, but now I feel weird from the episode.
I killed myself.
Don't do that. Bye.